This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we are cooking with Discover Newport. They've brought us Chef David from Stone Acre Pantry. And David, you are going to make a special dish today. What is it?
It's a sweet corn soup. Very summery.
Okay.
Rhode Island's known for their good sweet corn, mm-hmm. So that's what we're going to do.
All right. It's perfect time of year for that. So fairly minimal ingredients on the table here. Can you take us through what we'll need?
Sure. So this is the corn kernels, which we end up juicing, and it comes down to a nice puree, just like this.
When you say you're juicing it, can you just throw it in a blender, food processor?
You can put it in a juicer. Any home juicer will do it. So just as if you were juicing for fruit or something like that.
Perfect.
So
and very, it makes very easily this done. Kind of like paste here.
Yes. What I've done is juiced it, and then I've reduced it down to a nice thick consistency.
Excellent.
It kind of concentrates the corn and the juice.
So that's the corn there. What else do we need?
We have fresh tomatoes, fresh basil. This is a watercress puree, creme fraiche, and butter.
And you also have some herbs, too, that are going to incorporate into
Yes. I've started a stock here that they go into the corn stock.
So what are the different herbs that you've added to that?
Thyme, bay, and parsley stems.
Beautiful. And you said this is very light. So I know sometimes in the summertime with the heat, you don't want to either, you know, spend a lot of time in the kitchen or eat something really heavy that's going to weigh you down.
Exactly. This is a very light, very seasonal dish.
Beautiful. And I'm sure a lot of people may even be growing vegetables like this. Do you encourage people to go out there and, you know, buy local and use their local
things? Of course. And, you know, it just helps the community when you do that.
Mm-hmm. Now, where are you guys located?
We're located in Newport on Thames Street.
Okay. And you're taking part in a special soiree happening this weekend.
Summer soiree at the Jamestown Art Center.
Okay.
We're very, very lucky to be part of it.
All right. We are going to hear more about that soiree. And guess what? We also have some sangria in the kitchen today. So stay tuned for that. Back to you.
All right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. We're going to make sangria. Jesse Sgro is here from Sage Cellars.
Yes.
It's good to have you here.
Great to be here.
When you think of summer, people are sitting out on their decks, on their patios by the pool, or mm-hmm. going out, sitting someplace. Everybody has their own recipe for sangria. There's so many different ways of really mixing it together. What's your secret?
Oh, there really is a thousand different ways you can make sangria, but this is the way we like to make it at home.
Mm-hmm.
This is actually my wife's recipe.
You're giving away her secrets?
We're giving away her secrets today on live television, but the key to good sangria is the wine that you're using. This wine is from Arbor Hill. It's a winery out in the Finger Lakes of New York State.
Right.
And this is a rosé wine.
Mm-hmm.
And what makes this wine special for sangria is it just has a fabulous fresh crushed strawberry essence to it.
Right.
Which really enhances the fruitiness of the sangria.
Okay.
So the first step is the wine.
Mm-hmm.
And then what we like to do is we add some pour seltzer to the mix, which gives it a little bit of fizz. And some people use 7-Up, ginger ale. The great thing about using seltzer is that you're not adding any more corn syrup or anything unnatural to the product.
Okay.
This product is 100% natural. The sweetness is coming from the fruit juice. And this is two oranges freshly squeezed as well as one freshly squeezed lemon.
Okay.
And the wine itself.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the real secret ingredient to this is we put a little bit of calvados.
And what's that?
Calvados is a apple brandy, which is from France. And it's from a region called Normandy, which is very famous for its apples.
And is that easy for anybody to get if they were going to put this together?
Yes, you can find it at most liquor stores. We'll have at least one bottle.
And do you say after mixing this, do you let it sit for a little while? Does it become tastier when it sits and like?
Yes, sometimes it does. You want the flavors to sort of blend together.
Okay.
I just put in some fresh cut strawberries into the blend.
Just add to the flavor.
And you can really garnish it with anything. Kiwis, oranges, whatever you want.
Okay.
But the fruit's going to take on the flavor of the sangria.
Very good.
It's just going to enhance everything.
All right, we've got the sangria. We're going to put everything else together, and it'll be like a summer picnic we're going to have here on the Rhode Show this morning. Back to you. Our Newport has brought us Chef David Sturgeon from Stone Acre Pantry making sweet corn soup with fresh herbs. And we were saying it smells like summer in here.
Yes,
it really does. There's a strong smell and it really does get you going. All right, what do we got to do?
Okay, so we've taken the juiced corn and we've reduced it down to this thick puree there. Mm-hmm. And then we have our corn stock that we made with the actual ears of the corn stalks.
Okay.
Okay, how did you make this?
So after I took the kernels off the cob, mm-hmm. I juiced that and then took the cob and put it in with water, fresh herbs, onion, and a little bit of garlic.
Beautiful.
Okay. Okay.
So we have two things there?
Two things there, and that's the basis of the soup. It's very simple, mm-hmm. Very light and fresh.
We like that in the summertime.
And so if you want, so what we can do now is we'll take a little bit of the corn here, the mm-hmm. reduced corn.
Pop that in there.
Pop that in. And really what we've done is just concentrated all the sugars, and so it's a nice, nice sweet taste. And then we'll take the corn stock and add it to it. Just kind of fortifies the flavor a little bit.
Okay. Wow.
And then we'll let that heat up. Give it a nice stir. And you can, you can actually have this soup cold if you'd like.
Oh, all right.
Well, we're doing a hot soup, but it can be a cold soup as well.
Mm-hmm. Very versatile.
And what's the consistency have to be like of this? Just let it simmer for just a little while?
Yeah, you can let it simmer, and you can have it thick or as thin as you'd like.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So it's a very versatile soup.
All right.
And that's it.
That's it.
For right now, we'll let it heat up.
That was very simple.
That's easy.
Very simple.
Now, you said you will be featured in the soiree happening this Friday. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
It's a fundraiser they're doing for the Jamestown Art Center, mm-hmm. and it's from 6 to 9 p.m. It's going to be it's going to be a lot of fun. There'll be a band there, lots of different food and drinks.
Good to hear.
And tell everybody about the Stone Acres Pantry itself, if everybody doesn't, some people may not know.
Stone Acre Pantry, we're opening up in late summer.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's going to be seasonal American food, so.
Dishes like this on the menu? What else can we expect?
Dishes like this, things that are simply done, but very well executed.
And what time of year do you like cooking, like the summer food like we have mm-hmm. here, fall stuff? What's your specialty?
I really enjoy spring, and I don't know if that's because you go all winter with using the same vegetables and all of a sudden there's
right.
an explosion of
and
all
then
these
there it is
things.
Yeah, and yeah. you've been looking forward to it so
very
much.
Very abundant.
Yeah. All right, so we put this here. Now how long is this going to have to simmer?
So this is simmered as soon as it's hot, yep. and you get the consistency you'd like, then mm-hmm. then it's ready to go.
Okay.
So then we're able to bowl it up.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll bowl this up and see what we got.
Get you a bowl in there. There
some
we
of
are.
These. So. Pour this in here.
Yeah. Find a spoon. Yum.
And what are some of the other things that you can put in there? Because I noticed the finished one that you did, you added some...
I added fresh cherry tomatoes.
Okay.
Okay.
A little bit of creme fraiche and butter, which is totally optional.
Right.
Sure.
It could be.
And throw them on in there.
All right. So
let's
we'll put some of these in here. So we'll just add some of these cherry tomatoes.
Yeah, cherry tomatoes.
Okay. So put some.
I love
these
growing
in.
These in the summer. I'm sure a lot of people grow these at home.
Yeah. Put them all in there. Drop those in.
A little fresh chopped basil.
Okay.
Yum.
Sprinkle this in here.
Basil
out
in the
there.
Summertime.
Looks good.
And then this is a finishing salt. It's a smoked sea salt, so you can add a little bit of that if you'd like.
So what kind of flavor is this? If it's...
Huh.
It's just a very smoky salt.
Okay. All right, so put a little of this on, sprinkle that on top. And that's it. Oh,
you can smell the smoke on it.
You can really smell the smoke on it. I've never even heard of that before.
Huh.
Okay. All right, so we got that. Good.
Where is
that's it.
Now we need a spoon.
There you are.
Okay.
I'm going to
get this taste here, see what we got.
This is the true test. All right, you better not be nervous. How's that
really
piece of basil?
Piece of basil hanging from my... It's really, really good. It has so many different flavors mm-hmm. that you can taste for
and
summer.
And it looks just very light, too.
It is.
Sometimes
it's not very heavy.
You can't always do the heavy chowders and the thing. They're great, don't
mm-hmm.
get me
sure.
wrong.
And the thing
it's
about
nice.
This is you can add in different things that you'd like to add in, mm-hmm. garnish-wise. If you want to put lobster or shrimp in there, it's
right,
very versatile.
Right, you can put that in there, too.
Yum. All right,
this is
so
very good.
A lot of options. Grab your soup, grab your sangria. If you want to learn how to make both of these for yourself at home, head on over to the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.